Good morning. Today we're going to learn about the force of gravity and gravitational mass.
Hey guys.
Hey Bo.
Hi Bo.
Flippin' physics.
The symbol for the force of gravity is an uppercase F with a subscript of a lowercase g. The force of gravity is synonymous with a term you are probably more familiar with, and that is weight. The force of gravity is synonymous with weight. The symbol for weight is a capital W. I prefer to use the term force of gravity because it continually reminds you that the force of gravity is a force. The force of gravity is the attractive force that exists between the Earth and an object. The equation for the force of gravity is that the force of gravity equals the mass of the object multiplied by the acceleration due to gravity. Now, this mass is actually not inertial mass. Remind me, Bo, what is inertial mass?
Inertial mass is the measurement of inertia, or the measurement of the tendency of an object to resist changes in state of motion.
Correct. And the mass in this equation is gravitational mass. The gravitational mass is the mass that helps determine the force of gravity that exists between an object and the Earth. And that's what it is. It's the mass in this equation for the force of gravity caused by the Earth on an object. And despite this very different way of defining mass, it turns out that gravitational mass and inertial mass are experimentally identical. Therefore, unless there is a specific reason to identify the difference between these two types of masses, I will simply refer to both as mass. Billy, remind me, what is the accepted value for the acceleration due to gravity here on planet Earth?
9.81 meters per second squared.
Positive or negative?
Positive.
Are you positive?
Absolutely.
Good. The accepted value for the acceleration due to gravity here on planet Earth is positive 9.81 meters per second squared. Bobby, is the force of gravity a vector or a scalar?
All forces are vectors, so the force of gravity is a vector.
Then Bobby, what is the direction of the force of gravity?
I think down?
So you're not sure. Let me help you out.
Down. The force of gravity is definitely down.
Remember, the force of gravity on an object caused by the Earth is always toward the center of the planet or down. And if you forget, just drop something and watch it go down. Let's determine the dimensions for force. Billy, what is the base SI dimension for mass?
The base SI dimension for mass is the gram.
Actually, it's not the gram. I used to think that too, because we use grams so much in chemistry.
Yeah, that's right. My bad. The base SI dimension for mass is the kilogram.
And Bo, what are the dimensions for the acceleration due to gravity in base SI dimensions?
Meters per second squared.
So the base SI dimensions for the force of gravity, and actually all forces, are kilograms times meters per second squared. We give this a special name, we call it a Newton. We abbreviate that with a capital N, after Sir Isaac Newton, a great scientist whose three laws we're going to be learning very shortly, and whose name actually identifies the branch of physics we're learning currently, which is Newtonian mechanics, also called classical mechanics. Newtonian mechanics describes the motions of macroscopic objects or large objects like baseballs or planets moving at speeds small relative to the speed of light.
Right.
So then a Newton specifically is the force required to accelerate 1 kilogram of mass at 1 meter per second squared. Oh, we should probably go over the English units for force just to be complete. Who has an idea for what the English unit for force is?
It's the pound. It is the pound.
Yes, the English unit for force is the pound. The symbol for that is LB, which is an abbreviation for the Latin word libra. Libra, which was a unit of weight in ancient Rome, equivalent to approximately 11.5 ounces, and was the precursor to the pound. Therefore, a pound is defined as the amount of force necessary to accelerate 1 slug at 1 foot per second squared. Slug. You remember slugs, right?
Slug?
Slug?
Yeah, the slug, the base SI unit for mass.
Correct. But don't confuse the slug with the blob. The blob is actually 12 times greater than the slug because it's defined in terms of inches rather than feet. That's right. One blob equals 12 slugs. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.